Hello everyone, and welcome to a new IBMI RPG sample video. Today, I'd like to talk about the two new parameter built-in functions that IBM has released for RPG. These are PASSED and OMITTED. As you know, these two new functions can be used from version 7.4 and 7.5, but only if you have the corresponding PTFs installed. You can check the IBM documentation to see how can you use them. Let's go. Well, let me create a simple program where I'm going to show you an example of how to use PASSED and OMITTED. As in the rest of my examples, this program is going to be a program without cycle. So let me write the first line. Main. And let me declare the main procedure. Okay, for this example, as I will need to use parameters, it's easier to use a procedure. So let me create it with some parameters. Okay, as you can see here, I have three parameters for this procedure. All of them are constants. Okay, the first is an omit parameter. That means that can be passed with a value or with omit, but you must pass this parameter. Okay, the second one is a no pass parameter. So in this case, you can ignore the parameter in the call. But if you pass it, it cannot be omit. And in the third one, I have no pass and omit. This is the most complicated case, and I can pass a parameter or not. And if I pass it, it can be omit. Therefore, this procedure could be called in several different ways. It could be called with a single parameter, which could also be omit. It could be called with two parameters, and it could also be called with three parameters. Let me continue writing the code. Well, for the first parameter, I can write this. Okay, this way I can see what number of parameters that I have received. Okay, so if parts is greater than or equal to one, it's because I have almost the first parameter. So I can check the first parameter. And for if I want to know if the parameter is omitted, I can do this. And in this case, is omitted. Else, okay. Well, this is the old style. Okay. How can I do this now? Well, with the new functions, I can do this the same this way. I can use passed to know if the parameter is passed, has been passed or not. Okay, but if I want to know if the parameter is omitted, I have to use omitted. Okay, so this is the same as this, but it is more clear, I think. Okay, so we are going to remove this we're going to write it in the new style. Okay, so let me write for the second parameter. And for the last one, okay. Well, now let me make some calls to the procedure from the main procedure. Okay, let's do something like this. Let's check omit. As you know, you can call to this parameters with this opcode. A. Let me try it also with two parameters. Okay. And well, let's try with omit B omit, for example. B. Now let me compile the program. Great. And now let's go to the green screen and let's check how it works. Okay, let's open a debug session. Let's stop it here and let's call the program. Okay, let's make the first call. As you see, I have passed the parameter with omit. So if I enter to the procedure, the block that is going to run is this one because the parameter is omitted. And as I don't have more parameters, I'm running this block. PARM 2 is not available and PARM 3 is not available. Okay. Okay, in the second call, as the parameter is a value, let's enter again. The block that is going to be executed is this one. The rest works as in the first call. In the third call to the procedure, I'm using two parameters, both with a value. So the program is going to check first about the first parameter, and it's going to execute this block. And after that, the program is checking for the second parameter, and it is going to execute this other block too. Okay. For the third parameter, the block that is executed is this one. And for the last call, well, let's see how it works. In this case, it's also checking the last parameter. The first is omitted. The second one is passed. And the third one is also omitted. Okay, so as you can see, this is a very good way for checking the parameters of my procedures and programs too. This is also more clear and simple as the old method where I need to use PARMS, PARMNUM, or address. Okay, I hope you like this video. Press like if so, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. And as always, thanks for watching.